Well, the street dedication is just one of many things held this week as we head into Artscape weekend.
So we're counting down to the return of the East Coast's largest free arts festival. Artscape officially kicks off tomorrow evening. WJZ proud to be the media sponsor of the event. Unfortunately, we do have some rain in our forecast for the weekend, but that won't put a damp on the beloved festival because it will go on, rain or shine. Jessica Albert spoke with event organizers today to find out what you need to know before you go to Artscape this weekend.
As you can see, preparations are underway for Artscape, and WJZ has everything you need to know, including road closures.
We're just really setting up the final details right now. Vendors are arriving. Getting excited. You can feel the momentum in the air.
WJZ is proud to be the media sponsor for Artscape, an extremely popular festival celebrating Baltimore's arts community. It's making a comeback after a four-year pandemic hiatus. The festival is expanding into new neighborhoods this year and is being held during September, not August. The new date for the event drawing criticism from some in the community as it falls on the same weekend as Yom Kippur and other events in the same neighborhood. However, event organizers are confident the festival will go off without a hitch.
Baltimore is made up of creative people. That's what makes us a little funky and out there, and this is their opportunity to celebrate it.
Event organizers are also keeping an eye on the weather. Our First Alert meteorologists say rain is in the forecast this weekend, but Artscape will go on rain or shine and features indoor art shows.
More activities inside. There's Gamescape, there's Teenscape. We have a pop-up artist market inside the old Barnes & Noble in the Fitzgerald.
And if you're coming out to the festival, keep a lookout for road closures and detours.
Most notably, Mount Royal will be closed between St. Paul and McMeekin, as well as the intersections in between.
Artscape falls on the same weekend as World Car Free Day. MDOT is offering free rides on public transit.
We're definitely encouraging people to have a car-free weekend, so utilize all forms of transit, including bus and rail transportation, as well as e-bikes, e-scooters.
For a list of road closures and answers to your questions about Artscape, just head to our website, WJZ.com. Reporting in Baltimore, Jessica Albert for WJZ.